What time is it, my creatives? That's right, it's photo hacking time. And today we're going to learn how to make our links look a little bit more professional. And what I'm talking about is taking our Google Drive links and making them actually into, so that way people can't see that you're using Google Drive. So let me just show you an example here. So if I click the download link here, it's going to take me to Google Drive. And we don't want people to see this screen. And the problem with that is that if you have a really large file, it will show something to the fact that this file is too large for Google to scan for viruses. And I actually had a really crazy Karen on my Etsy shop freak out, accuse me of giving her a virus, all because of this message. And so I really wanted to simplify things and so that I won't have these issues, because you will not believe the astronomical amount of people on Etsy who don't know how to download a file, who don't know how to unzip a file. It just gets really complicated. So I'm going to show you some really cool things to do to get past that and to make your links look a little bit more professional. And let me show you what I mean. So I'm going to go back here. So I have download Halloween Photoshop brush set. And of course, you can download these for free. These are all free on my website. So if you click on that, it doesn't go to Google. It's going to take a few seconds. It's going to automatically download. Now, this is set two because I've already downloaded this twice just to test it. So now it's not going directly to Google, and this is exactly what we want. Now, I haven't found any videos on the tutorials on how to do this yet. So I guess I'm the first one to this. I've found people trying to sell software that doesn't work, and it's pretty annoying. I'm talking about G Drive, so if you've watched that tutorial, you could skip that because I actually have the solution for free. You're welcome. So the other thing that you could do is that you could create like a little web browser type like icon with like a Chrome browser type thing, and just double click on it and it will take you to the file like so. And it downloads it automatically. Okay, so if you click on properties and you paste the link in the URL there, and it will go to the file. And you can just put in the instructions here, download your file, and then you can make a new folder, name it. Okay, these are graphics. Inside, put it inside, and then zip it. And the reason why that is because Etsy does not offer that much storage. So how are we going to make these links? Let's go back to the, let's go ahead and get our link from Google Drive, and let's go ahead and create our link. So now I'm going to start on set two. So I'm going to click on download here. All right. And so at the very top, I'm just going to copy this link here. Okay. Copy. All right. Just going to minimize that window. And then I'm going to paste my link right here. Control V. And I'm going to put this in the description so you know what it is. Okay. So basically, this is the... Let me delete this here. Okay. So this is the part of the Google Drive link that you want right here. Okay. And you're going to copy that and you're going to paste it to the end. Okay. And I'm just going to delete this so we don't get confused. So you paste it to the end. So I have another one up here. Let me just delete this so we don't get confused. I'm going to copy this. Paste it here. So your Google link will go at the end here. Okay. So what you'll do to do this in Shopify, you'll copy it. And then you'll go back to your browser. So I'm in my Shopify links here. And I'm going to show you this because sometimes Shopify can be weird. I'm just letting you know that. So I'm just going to totally delete this link here, the number two. Delete. And I'm going to create a new word, download Photoshop brushes two. Download Photoshop brushes set two. Okay. Set two. All right. Highlight that, click on the link, paste it in here, and you're going to want to click a new window and then put download Halloween Photoshop brushes set two. Okay. Sure, I didn't spell Photoshop right. Okay, insert link. All right, so to make it red and underlined, you're gonna highlight it and click red and underline and then press save. Now, sometimes, I'm gonna go back out. Sometimes this may happen because your caching for your website may not catch up or something. So what you're gonna have to do is hit the F5 key on your keyboard, which refreshes everything. Go back to the blog, go back to page 3, and then click on the article, and it should be working. So if I click on that, it should work. So it worked. So now we have our Halloween brushes in here. Now, another thing I wanted to show you is sometimes in Shopify, there might be some errors. And what I mean by that is sometimes you'll have this that will show up in front of your links accidentally. So if you're getting 404 errors, sometimes Shopify, for whatever strange reason, does that automatically. So you could just come in here and delete it. All right, so that is pretty much it. That's how you mask your Shopify links, your Google links in Shopify and Etsy, and you don't have to worry about that anymore. Having them because the way that I was doing it before is that I would put a text link in here. You know, I would put open me download link inside. And then I would paste the link in here. And I'll just, for fuck's sake, paste the link in here. And for whatever reason, people would just take this link, and instead of putting it in their browser, they'd put it in Google. So they'd put it in Google like this. And normally it wouldn't download like that. It would get an error, okay? So I want them to put it up at the very top, but for some reason, I don't know what it is with the crowd on Etsy, they're not very computer savvy. So it's really a headache. The majority of my technical support customers are from, I don't know how to download my link. I don't know how to unzip a file. And so it can be quite overwhelming, especially when you have files in the thousands. Like if you have a shop that's like really large and you're doing a lot of digital downloads, it can be extremely frustrating. And they never, ever, ever message you saying, they never screenshot, or they just say, I can't download, which literally isn't enough information to go off of. It's not. Literally that tells me nothing. It's really troublesome, and a lot of times they will give you a 1-star review if they can't get a hold of you immediately. So a lot of times, the only time I get those one-star reviews is when literally the person is messaging me at 2 o'clock in the morning and I'm sleeping. So that can be a little frustrating, but I hope this solves an issue. I hope that, you know, you guys like this tutorial, and thank you so much for watching. If this helped you out, please subscribe. I noticed that 50% of my audience is not subscribed, and it is absolutely free. If you don't like it, you can always unsubscribe later, but it really helps me out. It helps me with the algorithm, and you know, I'm a smaller channel, so it really would benefit me greatly. Because I'm helping you, you can help me out. So thanks so much for watching, guys. Have a great day.